Welcome to the online lecture series of refrigeration and air conditioning. Here is Professor Lakshman Mani. This is a lecture on introduction to syllabus of refrigeration and air conditioning. Refrigeration and air conditioning is a third year mechanical engineering course which has teaching scheme and examination scheme as shown here. Refrigeration and air conditioning course includes the following units: applications of refrigeration and air conditioning and refrigerants, vapor refrigeration systems, multiple pressure refrigeration systems, psychrometry and air conditioning load, estimation, air conditioning systems, and air distribution systems. Let us discuss each unit in detail. First unit has two parts. Part A, that is applications of RAC. In this, you will be able to explain construction and working of domestic refrigerator, domestic air conditioner, automotive air conditioner, evaporative cooler, water cooler, commercial refrigeration, in that dairy, cold storage and ice plant. In commercial air conditioning, we will study about multiplex and hospital air conditioning. Part B is based on refrigerants. It is a medium of heat transfer used in the system. In this unit, you will be able to explain classification, designation, desirable properties of refrigerants, environmental issues, ozone depletion and global warming, ODP means ozone depletion potential, global warming potential, and life cycle climate performance. Then you will be also able to explain selection of environmental friendly refrigerants, secondary refrigerants means brine, antifreeze solutions which are used to reduce the freezing point of the refrigerant, zeotropes and azeotropes are the classes of the refrigerants. Then refrigerant recovery, reclaim, recycle and recharge will be studied. Second unit is vapor refrigeration system, which has again two parts. Part A is vapor compression system. In this unit, you will be able to explain working of simple vapor compression system. So this system is used in air conditioner, refrigerator and most of the refrigeration and air conditioning devices. This consists mainly four parts: evaporator, condenser, expansion valve and compressor. Representation of vapor compression cycle is on the TS diagram and pH diagram. So here is a pH chart for different refrigerants which is available. Output or output parameters of the VCC are COP means coefficient of performance, WER means energy efficiency ratio, seasonal energy efficiency ratio. These are applicable for air conditioner. IPLV means integrated power load value, and NPLV means non-standard power load value. Then here we study effect of operating parameters on COP, actual vapor compression cycle, then methods of improving COP by using flash chamber, subcooling and liquid vapor heat exchanger. Last, comparison between vapor compression cycle and reverse Carnot cycle is studied. Part B is vapor absorption systems. In this, you will be able to explain working of simple vapor absorption system, desirable properties of binary mixture, means mixture of refrigerant and solvent. So mostly your water is used here as a solvent and ammonia is used as a refrigerant. Then performance evaluation means finding the COP of simple VAS, practical VAS is done. Lithium bromide absorption system, Electrolux refrigeration system and applications of vapor absorption system will be included. Comparison between vapor compression cycle and vapor absorption system is studied. Third unit is multiple pressure refrigeration systems. In this, need of multi-stage systems, here number of compressors are provided to increase the pressure of the system. So here two-stage compression with flash gas removal and liquid intercooler can be studied. Then single compressor with multiple evaporator, in that individual and multiple expansion valves, individual compressors and cascade systems. Cascade system means combination of two vapor compression cycles having different boiling points. Then introduction to cryogenics and its applications will be studied. Unit 4 is psychrometry, which is the science of moist air. In this, you will be able to explain basic psychrometry, psychrometric processes, means different air conditioning processes, bypass factor of the coil, ADP means apparatus dew point temperature, mixing of two stream airs. Here in heat load calculation, these are the factors which are required in the numerical: sensible heat factor, room sensible heat factor, grand sensible heat factor and effective sensible heat factor. Then factors contributing to cooling load and numericals based on load analysis. This is a part A. Part B is human comfort, in that thermodynamics of human body. So here different kinds of heat which are entering to the body and leaving from the body will be studied. Comfort and comfort chart. Factors affecting human comforts, in that various factors means temperature, humidity, purity, cleanliness, which are studied. Infiltration and ventilation is a concept which is required in heat load calculation. Indoor air quality requirements which are required for the clean room concepts. Unit 5 has again two parts. First part is air conditioning systems. In this, you will be able to explain working of summer, winter and all round air conditioning systems. Based on the type of medium, all air system, all water system and air water systems. Then there are two types. One is a VRF means variable refrigerant flow and VAV means variable air volume, which are part of air conditioning systems. Then depending upon number of units, unitary means single unit and central air conditioning system, in that these are used for the big buildings and it ton refrigeration TR capacity is about 25 TR. Part B includes components of RAC, in that especially working of reciprocating screw and scroll compressors. Then heat exchangers, in that air cooled, water cooled and evaporative condensers comes. Then as a evaporator, there are two types: direct expansion, dry expansion type and flooded type evaporators. Types of expansion devices, in that capillary tube and thermostatic expansion wall will be studied. And last is operating and safety controls of these components will be studied. Unit number 6 has again two parts. Part A is air distribution systems, that is duct. Duct is a metallic branches which are used to convey the air from source to destination. So classification of ducts will be given. Duct materials are there different. Then pressure in the ducts, pressure losses which occurs in duct while flowing the air. Then equivalent diameter is one of the concept which is required to decide the shape of duct. Methods of duct system design, there are three methods: equal friction, velocity reduction and static regain method. Part B covers air handling unit, which has different parts. Fan coil unit. So air handling unit means it is a assembly where cooling coil, heating coil, blower, supply duct and return duct all are together. That is called as air handling unit. So it is a main part of the air handling, air distribution system. So here you can see these are the supply ducts and return ducts which are coming to the air handling unit. Fan coil unit is the inside unit, means cooling coil and fan together. Different types of fans will be studied. Then fan laws, filters which are required to filter the incoming air to avoid the dust particles, supply and return grille, means opening in the hall. Then different sensors are required, in that humidity, temperature and smoke sensors will be studied. References for this subject, these are some books which are mentioned here. You can use these books. Then scope of refrigeration and air conditioning. After studying this subject, you can work as a HVAC engineer. HVAC means heating, ventilating, air conditioning. It is a big hub in an industrial area. So in this HVAC area, we can have different branches or areas: domestic refrigeration and air conditioning systems, automobile air conditioning systems, central air conditioning systems, dairy refrigeration systems for the milk preservation, commercial air conditioning for the mall and multiplex, hospitals, ice plants, cold storage for preservation of long-term food storage, cold chain from the supply to consumer. The food is stored by using a link of refrigeration devices, that is called as cold chain. So here we can have different jobs as a service engineer, design engineer, installation and working and operation of the refrigeration and air conditioning plants. So if you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thank you.